Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the class. Yesterday, we were discussing the functions of the parliament. And in this context, we have seen the most important function of the parliament is the lawmaking function, that is called the legislative function. And besides, the parliament also exercises control over executive. Then it has important financial functions also. And other than these three important functions, we can see that the parliament has also a representative function. It represents the people of the country. It represents the diversity of the country. Then parliament presents a platform for debate and discussion on the matters of national importance as well as local matters. So besides, constituent powers are also there. With the parliament, in which the parliament amends the constitution, then electoral function, the parliament, the members of the elected members of the parliament elects the president and the vice president of India. Then it has some judicial function also. It can remove the president, vice president or judges of Supreme Court and High Court from the offices, which is called the process of impeachment. Now, we will see the powers of both the houses separately. In this connection, in this context, we must understand that the nature of both the houses are different. The Rajya Sabha is the representative of the states and the Lok Sabha is the representative of the people. And because of this difference in nature, we find that both the houses have different type of function. In some functions, they have same power. Both the houses are exercising same power. Both the houses have same power and authority over many matters. But there are some matters on which only Lok Sabha has powers, and there are also some matters on which only Rajya Sabha has power. So we will discuss these in this segment, and we can see here it is there is comparison of the power of the Lok Sabha and power of the Rajya Sabha. This also constitute a very important question. Compare the powers and functions of the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, and which house is more powerful in your opinion? स्टेट रीजन ऑल्सो, इस तरह के क्वेश्चन जो है वो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. ठीक है, तो लोकसभा की पावर्स, पावर्स ऑफ द लोकसभा, द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पावर वी ऑल नो, लॉ मेकिंग पावर. एंड यू मस्ट बी इन दिस बुक, द चैप्टर फेडरलिज्म विल बी इन द फॉलोइंग चैप्टर, वी विल रीड अबाउट फेडरलिज्म, बट यू मस्ट हैव knowledge of federal structure of the country. In class 10th, you have read about it, that India is a federal country, and under this federalism, we have divided the lawmaking power between the center and the state. There are three lists, and the power is divided by these three lists. The first list is union list, which consists those subjects on which the union, the center has the power to make laws. Then there is a state list on the matters, on the subjects of a state list, the state government, the state legislature, the state legislative assembly has the power to make laws. Then there is a concurrent list on this, on the subjects which are in the concurrent list, both the central parliament and the state legislature both have authority to make law on the subjects of concurrent list. But if there is any kind of conflict between the law which was made by the state legislature and the central parliament, then the laws made by the parliament will prevail. So this is the distribution of power between center and state in our federal structure. So Lok Sabha has the power to make laws on the subjects which are in the union list and concurrent list. Okay, and the same power is also Rajya Sabha is also having the same power. Rajya Sabha also has the power to make laws on the subjects which are mentioned in the union list and the concurrent list, and any ordinary bill which is not which is a non-money bill, that should not be a that should not be a money bill. Okay, an ordinary bill can be introduced in any of the house, and it is important, it is necessary for that bill to become an act, that it should be passed by both the houses of the parliament. And if there is deadlock between the two houses, suppose the non-money bill is there and the bill has been originated in Rajya Sabha, it has been introduced in Rajya Sabha, and Rajya Sabha passes the bill with simple majority. Okay, now the bill reaches the Lok Sabha, and now Lok Sabha is not pass the bill, because there may be some the Lok Sabha wants some changes in the bill, and it recommends some it send back, the Lok Sabha sends back the bill to the Rajya Sabha with its recommendation. And now what happened, what will happen, Rajya Sabha will reconsider the bill, and it will take into consideration the recommendations which was given by the Lok Sabha. Okay, and now suppose that the Rajya Sabha is not ready to accept the recommendations of the Lok Sabha, then what will happen? There is deadlock between the two houses of the parliament. So how this deadlock will be ended? There is a provision of joint meeting of both the houses of parliament in order to solve this problem. Okay, and in this joint sitting, what happens in this joint sitting, majority se jo pass ho jata hai, agar bill, if the bill passes by the simple majority, then the bill will be considered to be passed by both the houses, and now it will go to the president. Okay, so we see that in the non-money bill matters, both the houses of the parliament has same power. Okay, so this is very much clear to you. Now I don't think you have any kind of confusion. Now we will discuss about the money bill. Money bill can originate only in the Lok Sabha, and it cannot be introduced in the Rajya Sabha. Why this discrimination has been done by the constitution makers? Why money bill cannot be introduced in the Rajya Sabha? Can you think of the reason? I'm telling you the reason. Money bill means the bill which is related to money. Whatever money the government is having, whatever money the government wants to spend, that money belongs to the people of the country, because the earning of the government, the main source of the earning of the government is tax and revenues, and people are the taxpayers, people are giving the revenues. So the money of the country, the money which is to be spent by the government, that should be in the control of the people, because it is people's money. Okay, the money which the government is spending, the money does not belong to the government. Actually, that money belongs to the people of the country. So the people of the country must have control over the money. They are the owner of that money. So their approval is required. If the government wants to spend money, then the government has to take the approval of the people. But the government cannot take the approval of the people directly. So it will take the approval of the representatives of people who are there in the Lok Sabha. Okay, so this is the reason why in money matters, why the money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha, not in the Rajya Sabha. Okay, and another thing is also, suppose money bill, any money bill has been introduced in Lok Sabha, and the Lok Sabha passes it with the majority. Okay, and now it reaches the Rajya Sabha. Now Rajya Sabha cannot reject this bill. Rajya Sabha can make some recommendations. Rajya Sabha can suggest some changes in the bill, and it has to send back the bill within 14 days. If Rajya Sabha does not send back the bill within 14 days, then the bill will be considered to be passed by the Rajya Sabha. Are you getting it? अगर राज्य सभा के पास बिल जाता है, मनी बिल लोकसभा से पास होने के बाद द बिल गोज टू राज्यसभा. अगर राज्यसभा उसको 14 डेज के भीतर वापस नहीं करती है लोकसभा को, तो क्या होगा कि 14 डेज पास होने के बाद वो बिल जो है समझा जाएगा कि राज्यसभा ने पास कर दिया. ठीक है, वन कंडीशन इज दिस. देयर मे बी अनदर कंडीशन कि विद इन 14 डेज राज्यसभा सेंड्स बैक द बिल टू द लोकसभा, बट इट मेक्स सम सजेशंस, इट गिव इट्स रिकमेंडेशंस कि इसमें कुछ चेंजेस होने चाहिए. नाउ द बिल इज इन द लोकसभा विद द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ द राज्यसभा. नाउ द लोकसभा विल डिस्कस द मैटर, एंड इफ डिस्कस द मैटर, डिस्कस द रिकमेंडेशंस ऑफ द राज्यसभा, एंड इफ द लोकसभा इज ऑफ द ओपिनियन, द मेजोरिटी ऑफ द लोकसभा इज ऑफ द ओपिनियन दैट द रिकमेंडेशंस ऑफ राज्यसभा is not they don't want to accept those recommendation, then what happened that the bill will be considered passed. Okay, so it is not compulsory for Lok Sabha to consider the take into consideration the recommendations of the Rajya Sabha. Okay, and one more situation is there when the Rajya Sabha can reject the bill. No, Rajya Sabha has not accepted the bill. Still, there is no need of approval of the Rajya Sabha. The bill will be considered passed by both the houses of the parliament and it goes to president. So, this is about the non-money bill. Okay, now this is also the Lok Sabha approves all the proposals for taxation, budgets and annual financial statements. And in this regard, also we find that the Rajya Sabha has no power. It do not need to be approved by the Rajya Sabha. Any proposal for taxation or budget or annual financial statement need not to be approved by the Rajya Sabha. Okay. Now, we will see regarding the amendment of the constitution. In the amendment of the constitution, both the houses have same power. There is no discrimination between the both the houses of the parliament regarding the amendment of the constitution. Okay. Now, then again we see that both the houses have the same power in electing the president and vice president of India. The electoral college of the president and vice president consists of elected members of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. In this regard, both the houses have same power. Okay, and then removal of president, vice president, judges of Supreme Court and High Court. In the removal of all these people, both the houses exercise same power. Both of them have same power. But in this regard, one thing which is important that the procedure for removal of vice president can be initiated only in Rajya Sabha. Okay. अगर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट को हमें रिमूव करना है तो उसका जो प्रपोजल होगा वो केवल राज्यसभा में ही स्टार्ट हो सकता है. ओके, इट कैन अलोन इनिशिएट द प्रोसीजर फॉर रिमूवल ऑफ वाइस प्रेसिडेंट. क्यों, व्हाई इज इट सो? बिकॉज वाइस प्रेसिडेंट इज द एक्स ऑफिशियो चेयरमैन ऑफ द राज्यसभा. ओके, हूएवर इज द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया, ही विल बी द चेयरमैन ऑफ द राज्यसभा. दैट्स व्हाई इट राज्यसभा हैज द पावर टू इनिशिएट द प्रोसीजर फॉर रिमूवल ऑफ वाइस प्रेसिडेंट. ओके, एंड देन वी सी देर आर सम अदर मैटर्स इन विच द लोकसभा हैज मोर पावर. दिस इज इन दिस रिगार्ड लोकसभा हैज मोर पावर. ओके, देन कंट्रोलिंग द एग्जीक्यूटिव. बोथ द हाउसेज ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट हैज पावर टू कंट्रोल द एग्जीक्यूटिव. इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट दैट द एग्जीक्यूटिव एग्जीक्यूटिव होल्ड्स इट्स पोस्ट द रियल एग्जीक्यूटिव दैट इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर विथ हिज कैबिनेट होल्ड्स इट्स ऑफिस अंटिल इट हैज द सपोर्ट ऑफ द मेजोरिटी इन द लोकसभा. सो इन दिस वे वॉट हैपन्स दैट द लोकसभा हैज द पावर टू पास द वोट ऑफ नो कॉन्फिडेंस against the government. And if the vote of no confidence is passed by the Lok Sabha by simple majority, then the Prime Minister has to resign from his office. So in this regard, we see that this no confidence motion can be started only in the Lok Sabha, not in the Rajya Sabha. Okay, in this connection also, in this context also, the Lok Sabha has more power than the Rajya Sabha. Okay, but in other matters like asking questions, asking supplementary questions, then passing of resolution and motions, half an hour discussion, 0 hour, all in all these regards, both the houses have same power. The ministers and the Prime Minister, both of them are, all of them are responsible towards both the houses of the Parliament. In any house of the Parliament, the ministers can be asked questions by the member of the Parliament, either in Rajya Sabha or in Lok Sabha, and the ministers have to give satisfactory answer to the question. If their answer is not satisfactory, then the opposition may stage a walkout also, and they can disrupt all the proceedings of the house. So in this connection, other than no confidence motion, other than this motion, both the houses exercise same control over the executive. Okay, now there is another important power of the Lok Sabha, and that is approval of the proclamation of emergency. Whenever the executive, the real executive, with the signature of the ceremonial executive, proclaims the emergency, then this proclamation must be approved by the by majority in the Lok Sabha. Okay, and that's all. One more thing, there is some provisions which give Rajya Sabha more powerful. In these three regards we have seen, regarding money bill and budget and taxation, all these in matters, the Lok Sabha has more power. The Lok Sabha has the power to pass the no confidence motion against the government, and the Rajya Sabha is not having this power. Then approval of the proclamation of emergency is also needed. Lok Sabha must approve the proclamation of emergency. So in these three aspects we can see that the Lok Sabha has more power, but in one regard we can see that the Rajya Sabha is more powerful, and that is sometimes it happens that in the national interest, it is important for the parliament to make laws on those subjects which are given in the state list. So the Union Parliament has the power, it has the power to make laws on those subjects which are there in the, which are mentioned in the state list. But the Parliament cannot, Union Parliament cannot do this without the approval of the Rajya Sabha. It has to take the approval of the Rajya Sabha. Then only it can, then only the Union Parliament can make laws on the subjects of state list. Okay, so because why this special power has been given to Rajya Sabha? Because Rajya Sabha is the representative body of the states. It represents the states. So it is there to protect the powers of the states. It is there to protect the interest of the states. So if there is any matter which affects the state, it must be referred to Rajya Sabha. It must be approved by the Rajya Sabha. If the Union Parliament wants to remove a matter from the state list, and it want to shift this matter from the state list to either to union list or to concurrent list, then the approval of the Rajya Sabha is necessary. So this provision adds to the strength of the Rajya Sabha. This power is not given to the Lok Sabha. However, experience shows that the members of the Rajya Sabha represent their parties more than they represent their states. So we have the experience of 70 years of governance, and in these 70 years it has been experienced that in the Rajya Sabha the members vote, not the members behave not according to the interest of their states, respective states. They are not there to protect the interest of their respective states, but they are they behave according to the parties they belong. So because party affiliation is much more powerful than the affiliation to the states, so in this way we can say that the Rajya Sabha is actually not representing the states. It is only party politics. Now we can see some powers which are exercised only by the Lok Sabha. We have discussed this, and you can see the Rajya Sabha cannot initiate, reject or amend any money bill. I have told you all the process has been discussed with you. The Council of Ministers is responsible to the Lok Sabha and not Rajya Sabha. Therefore, Rajya Sabha can criticize the government. It has the power to criticize the government. It has the power to question the government, but it cannot remove the government. The removal of the government, the removal of the Prime Minister and Prime Minister is given to the Lok Sabha only. Okay, so and I have told you the reason also, because Rajya Sabha is why the control over executive in this matter Lok Sabha has more power. Why Rajya Sabha cannot pass, cannot start a vote of no confidence motion? Because Rajya Sabha is not the representative of people. It is not a body which represents the people of the country. It is not directly elected by the people. It is indirectly elected by the people. So Rajya Sabha should not have the power to remove the Prime Minister. It is only Lok Sabha which is representing the people. The members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. Okay, so our constitution makers get this power of removal of the prime minister only to the Lok Sabha. Okay, because we have a democracy, democratic form of government, and this democracy, the people are the final authority. The desire, the wishes of the people should prevail. And who is representing the wishes of the people? Who is representing the interest of the people? It is represented by the members of the Lok Sabha. So, our constitution makers give this power only to the Lok Sabha. So, other than these two, there are other spheres in which both the houses have same power. Okay, now we will see the process of law making. Okay, in this process, first of all, you must understand this types of bill. There are two types of bill. One is government bill and the another one is private members bill. What is government bill and what is a private member bill? When a bill, first of all, you should know what is bill. Bill is a draft of the proposed law. जब किसी लॉ की जो ड्राफ्टिंग होती है कि अभी वो लॉ बना नहीं है, अभी हमने सिर्फ ड्राफ्ट किया है, उसकी एक तैयार किया, एक खाका तैयार किया है, देन इट इज कॉल्ड बिल. ओके, अ बिल इज अ ड्राफ्ट ऑफ द प्रपोज्ड लॉ. जो लॉ हम चाहते हैं कि बन जाए, उसके लिए हमने ड्राफ्टिंग कर दी है, एंड दैट ड्राफ्ट इज कॉल्ड बिल. नाउ देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ बिल ब्रॉडली, गवर्नमेंट बिल एंड प्राइवेट मेंबर बिल. गवर्नमेंट बिल इज दैट बिल विच इज प्रपोज्ड बाय अ मिनिस्टर. अ बिल प्रपोज्ड बाय अ मिनिस्टर इज डिस्क्राइब्ड एज गवर्नमेंट बिल. एंड अ बिल विच इज प्रपोज्ड बाय अ नॉन मिनिस्टर, देन इट इज कॉल्ड प्राइवेट मेंबर्स बिल. आई हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस अर्लियर ऑल्सो, एंड दीज थिंग्स शुड बी कंप्लीटली क्लियर इन योर माइंड. वेन अ बिल इज गवर्नमेंट बिल, देन दैट बिल विल पास फ्रॉम द लोकसभा. देर इज कंप्लीट, देर इज नो किसी तरह का वो शक की गुंजाइश नहीं होती. देर इज नो डाउट दैट अ बिल विच इज प्रपोज्ड बाई अ मिनिस्टर विल बी पास्ड फ्रॉम द लोकसभा और नॉट पास्ड. वाई? बिकॉज द मिनिस्टर इज द एग्जीक्यूटिव, इज द काउंसिल, इज द मेंबर ऑफ द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर, एंड द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर इज विल होल्ड इट्स पावर ओनली ओनली व्हेन इट हैज द सपोर्ट ऑफ द मेजोरिटी इन द लोकसभा. तो जब मेजोरिटी का सपोर्ट है, तभी तक वो मिनिस्टर प्राइम मिनिस्टर रहेगा, और जब तक प्राइम मिनिस्टर रहेगा तभी तक मिनिस्टर भी रहेंगे. तो जब मिनिस्टर ने किसी बिल को प्रपोज किया है, और तो उस बिल के पास होने में कोई शक की गुंजाइश नहीं होती है, दैट बिल इज आराम से वो पास हो जाता है, क्योंकि मिनिस्टर जो है उसको मेजोरिटी का उसके पास सपोर्ट ऑफ मेजोरिटी है. ओके, एंड व्हेन अ नॉन मिनिस्टर प्रपोजेज अ बिल, देन व्हाट हैपेंस? एंड इफ इट इज नॉट सपोर्टेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट, इफ द बिल इज नॉट सपोर्टेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट, देन दैट बिल कैन नॉट बी पास्ड, बिकॉज मेजोरिटी इज विद द गवर्नमेंट एंड गवर्नमेंट इज अपोजिंग द बिल विच इज प्रपोज्ड बाय द नॉन मिनिस्टर, देन इट कैन नॉट बी पास्ड. बट वेन इफ द नॉन मिनिस्टर इज प्रपोजिंग अ बिल एंड इट हैज द सपोर्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, देन इन दैट केस इट कैन पास फ्रॉम द लोकसभा. ओके, सो अगेन दिस गवर्नमेंट बिल, दिस बिल कैन अगेन बी बाइफर्केटेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, नॉन मनी बिल एंड मनी बिल. मनी बिल विच इज रिलेटेड विद द मनी, एंड नॉन मनी बिल विच हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द मनी. एंड देन दिस नॉन मनी बिल इज ऑल्सो टू टाइप्स, ऑर्डिनरी बिल एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट बिल. सो दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू, एंड यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड ऑल दिस कैटेगराइजेशन. Now we will discuss the process of bill, how a bill becomes a law. What is the process which is adopted in order to convert a bill to a law? This will be discussed in the next class. Okay.